feeling in Chicago. Let's go. Okay, the next song I'd like to do is one that I wrote for my wife, Nancy. And she's here with us tonight. Okay, Max, this is for you, man.
Yeah. Thank you.
So you may have noticed that people come along to the shops holding signs. And it's great, we love it, really love it. And the only thing is that you're actually trying to remember your chords, you're trying to remember the lyrics, trying to sing it right, and your mind says, don't look at the signs. And then there's another little voice in there that says, yeah, come on, that's awesome. So you too. Let's see. With you. George, Colin, and Duff. Anyway, the charge was £5, so we paid £1 each, and the deal was that we'd each keep it for a week. So John kept it for a week, I kept it for a week, George kept it for a week, Colin kept it for a week, and Duff kept it for 20 years. Anyway, so the song that we recorded that day, we kept it. It's a song we're going to do now. Smiling from the teacher, smiling from the based on this riff. John would sing, "Love me do," and then he'd play a harmonica, "Love me do." And George wanted to have it happen, like, "Love me." He wanted it to happen all at once. So he turns to me in the middle of this session. He says, "Paul, would you mind singing to Love Me Do?" I go, okay. Because, you know, I'm already nervous now, I'm like panicking. So he said, "Yeah, okay, I'll do it." So I did it, and to this day, when I listen to the record, I can still hear that little Love Me Do. But not tonight.
Whatever.
we're back in the 60s. There's a lot of troubles going on, particularly in the southern states of America, like in Alabama and Arkansas, over civil rights. And when we hear about this, like in England, I wanted to try and write a song that, if it ever reached the people going through those struggles in places like Little Rock and Birmingham and Alabama, that if the song ever reached them, it might just give a little bit of hope, a little bit of inspiration. Blackbird singing in the dead of night, tiki's rubbing the wings and learning to fly. All your life you roll the waiting for this moment to arrive. Blackbird singing in the dead of night, some eyes and learn to see. All your life you were only waiting for this moment to be free. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Into the light of the dark black night. Singing in the dead of night, tiki's rubbing wings and learning to fly. All your life you were only waiting for this moment to arise. Blackbird, fly. Blackbird, fly. Into the light of the dark black night. Blackbird singing in the dead of night, take these summer nights and learn to see. This moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. You were only waiting for this moment to be free. Say to people what you really feel. sometimes you want to pay someone a really nice compliment. I think, no, I'll say it next week. I'll tell them another time. And especially, you know, with us, like, when we're in the Beatles, we're just a gang of young Liverpool lads, you know. So we wouldn't get into stuff like that. You can't imagine us saying, "I love you, man." It just never happened, you know, because it just wasn't the thing. But say what happens is then, so you put it off, and then sometimes it can be too late. And this next song is a conversation that I wrote after John died, in the form of a conversation that I didn't get to have with him. And if I said, "I really knew you well," what would your answer be? If you were here today, something nice to say to someone, get it said. So we'll lift the moon down, and this next song is from our most recent album, a couple years ago now. And this song is the song he's talking about on the most to play. Because in it, it says, "Who's got the ball?" You see, that's the joke. This is called Queenie.
Yeah.
So we played you the oldest song that we ever recorded. And now we'd like to come a bit more up to date and play you the most recent song that I've been involved in. And if you want to sing along with it, the words come up on the screen. We'd like to play a song now, which is off the Sgt. Pepper album. And that album was released 50 years ago this year. I'm not sure that's true. I think it sounds more familiar. But it is. Here's a song.
I don't need no one to love her.
Something else that I let you know. You don't want me on the ground. You don't want me now.
I'm not afraid to die. Thank you.
deserve. And you know, we'd always wanted to go to Russia. We'd always wanted to go, if for nothing else, just to play the bad song. We did get invited a few years ago to go and play in Red Square in Moscow. And we were actually the first rock and roll band ever to play in Red Square in Moscow. We had a great time, you know, it was really cool. Obviously we did that number twice. We had a great time. The audience were fantastic. It was a great evening. And there was the Kremlin, Red Square, the whole thing, you know. But what was interesting for us, I like to tell this story, is that backstage, there was quite a few members of the Russian government, because the Kremlin wasn't far away. And so they were all hanging around backstage. I think it was the free vodka. Anyway, one of my guys comes up to me and says, "Hey, see that man there? He is the defense minister of the whole of Russia." I said, "Whoa, that's a big job, you know?" And yeah, sure enough, he was. He comes up to me. I'm interested to talk to him. He says, "Paul, first record I ever bought was Love Me Do." And another guy comes over, and another guy says, he's also in the government, you know? He comes over, says, "Bob," he says, "we learned to speak English from listening to Beatles records." I said, "Wow, you can read me." He looks me right in the eye and goes, "Hello, goodbye." That's true.
Just the words.
Time to do that. Yeah, 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 yeah. Yeah, 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 yeah. Woo! Woo! It's another level. Okay, and not me about this time. We try and pull someone up out of the audience just for another laugh. So, let's see who we got tonight. Come on, man. Oh. Okay. So, there does come a time when we've got to go home.
No.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
No.
Oh, yeah.
No.
And listen, it's roughly about the same time that we've got to go home anyway, so don't worry about it. So we have had a fantastic time here tonight. We have two great nights in Chicago and a fantastic audience. But to bring a big show like this to you, we've got a few people we want to thank. We want to thank Pablo out front, who's on the sound, and we want to thank Rollins on the lights, Tony Baker and his crew on the video screens, Rollins on the monitors, Shaky who's on the pyro, all the crew here who put together all the pianos. The wiggers who put it up and the truckers who bring it to you. And many more people sign. So let's hear it for the best crew on the planet. Yeah. I want to thank this fantastic band of mine. I'll tell you what, we also want to thank our fantastic promoter, we never thank him, Barry Marshall. We love Barry. But most of all, as we say at the end of every show, we want to thank you for coming along. So give yourselves an applause. You've been great, thank you. To get back home. love you, and you know what? We will see you next time!